and welcome back to my channel. My name is Karin from Extraordinary Fitness, and today we are going to look at the roll. It's a hip roll. It's a single hip roll, so you can do one or you can do several. It's kind of slow, so because you always have to bring your leg back in, but it's really good to train because it helps you later on for the Jade roll. And I know that many of you are having this on the bucket list. It has the same kind of elbow pressure. So try and give it a go. But before we start, subscribe, give us a thumb up, leave a comment below, share it with others so we get more and more in the aerial community. Let's go to the tutorial. To start, I will tell you the entrance, which is easiest because you have to come in your hip hold. And I have experienced that several times also with my students, that it's like, how should I get into the hip hold first at all? You can check my previous tutorial. I have one about it, where you go in with a really pretty cross shape rolling into it. For now, I suggest that you just grab on the side you want to have hanging in your hip. I want to hang in my left hip. So I'm going to roll to that side. I'm going to go with my upper body behind the hoop. I'm going to go close, close, close. And then I roll kind of, as you can see, I roll kind of over my hip. I'm taking this leg also behind the hoop. I'm rolling down. This one is going to pike, so don't leave it straight. Pike it downwards. Hold here. And then you can down to your hip hold position. So from your hip hold position, what you're going to do is you're going to go with both of your hands between your legs and try to grab up. So try to come maybe at this high, because you will have to pull yourself kind of in that direction. So if you have your hands just too low, it won't work. So you have to kind of grab yourself a little bit higher. Your outside leg, your free leg, you can bend it and kind of circle it inside. But what is going to happen is you have your leg here. You're going up with your hands. You have to grab up, otherwise it's kind of difficult. Your leg is going to circle in. You're going to go around, push with your elbow, and take your leg around. And again, circle, push, and go around. As you could see now, my elbow is pushing myself over the hoop. If I don't do that, and if I don't keep this, the elbow on my hip in order to go around, I will never come around. So this is actually one of the biggest part when you do it. I will try to do it one more time slowly, but slowly is kind of harder. Take a little bit speed. To come around, you need to keep this kind of pike position and use your elbow to push down on the hoop. I tried one more time. So you can also go from the bottom into the hip hold, which means you're holding on the side, and you're gonna lift the inside leg, the one which is closer, over the hoop. And again, you have to pike it. If you leave it straight, it feels like you don't get into the position. So kind of pike it over there. Hanging a little bit on the side of the hoop as well, coming up with your hands, going in and pushing your elbow. So this elbow push until your leg, the top of your leg, is coming onto the hoop. Then that one can push and continue. So it's kind of, the arm is pushing, and when your leg has gone around and reaches, you can take your elbow away. And like this, you can do the roll. For training, I recommend to, for example, do the mount, the stomach mount. You have this one also in a previous tutorial. For me, where you really stand, have your upper body over and try to get your legs over the hoop. I would work on this one because it's kind of the same pike position. You have to lift over. And you can as well exercise on the floor. Of course, that you kind of train all this going over your head and back down. They are really good to work on just for having this pike position, because that this one is important. Negative pull-ups, that you are hanging on the hoop with bent arms and then slowly letting yourself out for having this strength. This is the entire tutorial. I really hope you have fun with it. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. I'm happy to answer it. Also, requests for other tutorials, just drop them below. Thanks for watching, and see you next week for a new tutorial. Bye.